Hello guys, and welcome back to another tutorial. Today I am going to be showing you how to make food that's basically like golden food, like golden apples, golden carrots, stuff like that. The first thing that we actually need to do in order to actually demonstrate this is to take some damage, so I'm just going to jump up here and see if I can't find a suitable location to jump off, like that cliff over there. So we'll hopefully break an ankle and be able to eat some food. Well, we can eat some food right now. I'll do it anyway, so there we go. Okay, so yeah, so if you just basically eat it, it gives two effects, absorption and regeneration two. So if I were to take damage right now from that fall, it would basically do damage to the golden hearts and not the the actual heart. So that's basically how absorption works. And as far as the regeneration, it'll just make sure that your health is regenerating. So without further ado, let's hop into the tutorial and I'll show you how it all works. So I have three elements right here. The first element is the actual procedure for the effects. The other one is the food item, and the last one is the recipe for the actual food. So as you can see, I just used golden nuggets and a regular beet to put a to make basically a golden beetroot. So that's basically all the recipe is. And for the settings for the food, I have the texture. I have named it something that I could basically remember or that makes sense. It's under the food tab. You can actually select your own creative tab if you have one. It can stack up to 64. The nutrients value is 6. That is, I believe, 3 hunger. I'm pretty sure it's half hunger each digit. So it would be like 3. And then it's not able to be used for food for dogs, it's not always edible, and it does not have a global effect. Eating speed is the default 32, and the food animation is eating. The next thing that I have over here is when food eaten, I have the procedure to run, so you'll want to set the procedure to run here. So if we go to the procedure now, we can take a look how it's all set up. In order to get these potion effects, what you want to do is go to, I believe, entity. Yeah, you want to go to entity, and then you want to drag the add potion with level, and then you want to select your level. Now, if you want level 1, you're going to set this to 0, but if you want level 2, then you're going to set it to 1. If you want level 3, you set it to 2, and so on. Now the duration is the ticks of how long it's going to last. It's not actually seconds. So going back to blocks and stuff like that, 20 ticks is 1 second. So what you want to do is multiply 20 by a number that you want to the number of seconds you want it to basically continue for. So this is exactly 15 seconds. If you wanted 30 seconds, it'd be 600. If you wanted 1 minute, it'd be 1200. So that's basically the general ticks that you will be using. Now for the regeneration, what you want to do is scroll down until you find regeneration. You can use any of these effects as well, not just those particular ones. So if you wanted to make food with like blindness or something, then you can do that. Regeneration is right here, so you would select that. Absorption is, I believe, a little bit further down right here under health boost. So you want to select that one. And that's pretty much all there is to putting a some potion effects into it. You just need to save it, make sure it's linked properly, and most likely you'll need a recipe depending on how your mod's set up. If you're using a custom crafting recipe, then you're going to have to set it up through that. But for vanilla Minecraft, then you're just going to set this up. Outside of that, hopefully you guys found something useful about the video. If you did, let me know in the comments below what you learned. Also, rate the video. It does help with getting it on seen on YouTube and stuff like that. And if you want to stay notified, don't forget to click the silver bell. And I'll see you guys next time. Thanks for watching. Peace out.